explain radioactive equilibrium. And now you can also get my lecture notes from chepekmedia.co.nf. The disintegration of radioactive element leads to the formation of a daughter element. If daughter element is radioactive, it will also undergo the disintegration to produce another daughter element. The process goes on till a stable non-radioactive element is formed. Therefore, A on disintegration gives B and B on disintegration gives C. That state, when the rate of formation of B from A is the same as its rate of disintegration into C, the amount of B in the source will remain unaltered. It will not change with time. Then B is said to have attained radioactive equilibrium. It is irreversible. The condition for radioactive equilibrium is that the rate of formation of a daughter element must be equal to its rate of disintegration. So A is converted into B and B is converted into C. Here, rate of formation of B is equal to rate of disintegration of B. But rate of disintegration of A is equal to rate of formation of B. Therefore, rate of disintegration of A is equal to rate of disintegration of B. Therefore, we can write minus dNa divided by dt is equal to minus dNb divided by dt. But minus dN by dt is also given by lambda n. Therefore, equation becomes lambda aNa is equal to lambda bNb, or Na by Nb is equal to lambda b by lambda a. Also, lambda is related to t half with the relation lambda is equal to 0.693 divided by t half. Therefore, the equation becomes Na by Nb is equal to lambda b by lambda a is equal to t half of a divided by t half of b. This equation is known as radioactive equilibrium equation. Applications. If we know the amount of two radio elements and if the half-life of one is known, we can find out the other or vice versa. If we know the amount of two radioactive element and decay constant of any one of it, we can find out that of the other and vice versa. The radioactive equilibrium mentioned above is known as secular equilibrium. The decay constant of the elements in the equilibrium, say lambda A and lambda B, differ from each other widely. But if lambda A and lambda B not differing much from each other, then Na by Nb becomes lambda B minus lambda A divided by lambda A. This type of equilibrium is known as transient or temporary equilibrium. So let's differentiate between the chemical equilibrium and radioactive equilibrium. Chemical equilibrium is reached when rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction. Radioactive equilibrium is reached when rate of formation of species is same as its rate of disintegration. That is, Na by Nb is equal to lambda b by lambda a is equal to t half of a divided by t half of b. It can be reversed. It cannot be reversed. The product can give reactant back. The product cannot produce reactant back. It is affected by temperature and pressure. It is unaffected by temperature and pressure. It is reached within short time. It reaches after a long time. It is found in non-radio species only. It is found in radioactive species only. So now let's try to solve some of the numerical problems based on these equations. A uranium mineral contains radium, having reached secular equilibrium with uranium. The half-life of radium is 1600 years. The mineral on analysis shows that it contains 2.812 into 10 to the power 6 atoms of uranium for each atom of radium. What is the half-life of uranium? So in this case, we have number of atoms of uranium and U is equals to 2.812 into 10 to the power 6 and number of atoms of radium is 1. Half-life of radium is given, that is 1600 years, and half-life of uranium we have to find out. So according to radioactive equilibrium, n uranium divided by n radium is equal to t half of uranium divided by t half of radium. Now let's put the values. So 2.812 into 10 to the power 6 divided by 1 is equals to T half of uranium divided by 1600. Therefore T half of uranium becomes 2.812 into 10 to the power 6 into 1600, which comes 4499.2 into 10 to the power 6, or we can say 4.499 into 10 to the power 9 years. Let's try to solve another problem, that is 1 gram of radium is in radioactive equilibrium with 0.59 mm cube of radon at NTP. The half-life of radium is 1600 years. What is the half-life in days of radon? Given that atomic weight of radium is 226, atomic weight of radon is 222. In this case, we have weight of radium which is given 1 gram. So let's convert into number of moles by dividing with atomic weight. So 1 divided by 226 moles, which is 4.425 into 10 to the power minus 3 moles. Volume of radon is also given, that is 0.59 mm cube. So let's convert it into cm cube by multiplying with 10 to the power minus 3. As per the relation of the ideal gases, 22,400 cm cube of ideal gas at NTP is equivalent to 1 mole of ideal gas. Therefore, we can say 0.59 into 10 to the power minus 4 cm cube of radon gas at NTP must be equivalent to x mole of radon gas. This on cross multiplication gives x is equals to 0.59 into 10 to the power minus 3 cm cube divided by 22,400 cm cube, which is 2.634 into 10 to the power minus 8 moles. Also, half-life of radium is given, which is 1600 years, and half-life of radon we have to calculate. Therefore, according to radioactive equilibrium, N of radon divided by N of radium is equals to T half of radon divided by T half of radium. Let's put the values. We get 2.634 into 10 to the power minus 8 divided by 4.425 into 10 to the power minus 3 is equals to T half of radon divided by 1600. So T half of radon becomes 2.634 into 10 to the power minus 8 divided by 4.425 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 1600, which comes 9.524 into 10 to the power minus 3 years. Now let's convert it into days by multiplying with 365 days. So it becomes 3.476 days. Let's try another problem. Uranium-235 has a half-life of 7.2 into 10 to the power 8 years, and its daughter element thorium-231 has a half-life of 24.75 hours. What is the weight of thorium-231 in equilibrium with 1 gram of uranium-235? So here we have half-life of uranium-235 is equals to 7.2 into 10 to the power 8 years. Let's convert this also in hours. So it becomes 7.2 into 10 to the power 8 into 365 days into 24 hours. It becomes 6.31 into 10 to the power 12 hours. Half-life of thorium-231 is given, which is 24.75 hours. Weight of uranium is given, which is 1 gram, and weight of thorium we have to calculate. So according to radioactive equilibrium, N of thorium divided by N of uranium is equals to T half of thorium divided by T half of uranium. Also, N of thorium is weight of thorium divided by atomic weight of thorium into Avogadro's number. Similarly, N of uranium is equals to weight of uranium divided by atomic weight of uranium into Avogadro's number. Let's put these in equation number 1. So, N of thorium divided by N of uranium becomes weight of thorium divided by weight of uranium into atomic weight of uranium divided by atomic weight of thorium, which is equals to T half of thorium divided by T half of uranium. This is equation number 2. And now we can put the values. So weight of thorium divided by 1 gram, that is weight of uranium, into 235 divided by 231 is equals to 24.75 divided by 6.31 into 10 to the power 12. Let's rearrange this equation. So weight of thorium becomes 24.75 divided by 6.31 into 10 to the power 12 into 231 divided by 235, which on calculation gives 3.856 into 10 to the power minus 12 grams